Hi, I'm Tom Coffin, CEO and president and co-founder of Simply Reliable Incorporated. Welcome to the SmartPRENEUR podcast. What's a SmartPRENEUR, you might ask? Well, a SmartPRENEUR, in our opinion, is someone that focuses on working on their business, not just in their business. And our SmartPRENEUR podcasts are designed to bring you some relevant information each week about your business and different parts of that business. It could be marketing, it could be workflow, it could be labor, it could be business operations, many things that we'll talk about each week on the podcast. You can also check out our SmartPRENEUR blog at simplyreliable.com. And of course, our SmartPRENEUR podcast is brought to you by Simply Reliable, makers of Smart Office and Design Machine, the complete end-to-end solution for business process for systems integrators. So thanks for joining us today, and I hope you enjoy the show. This week on the SmartPRENEUR podcast, our guest is Manny Salomon, founder, branding strategist, and creative director of WWDB Integrated Marketing. Please welcome Manny Salomon. Hey, Manny, welcome back to the SmartPRENEUR podcast. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good, thanks.
Awesome. Well, SmartPRENEURs, we've got a great opportunity to talk about the latest SmartPRENEUR blog that Manny has written, and it's called Marketing, Wash, Rinse, and Repeat. And, you know, we've talked a lot about workflow on the SmartPRENEUR podcast, and this is a very similar kind of subject. Yeah, you need to understand what you're doing and your plan, stuff like that, and work it over and over again. So I was wondering, Manny, as I was reading this blog that you wrote, is, did you ever get a request from someone that says, okay, you've built this ad for me, you know, and single ad, okay, I'm just going to run that same ad over and over and over again, and I'm all done, you know. I don't need to do anything else but that. Just continually run that. You know, what do you tell that person and about iteration and versus just repeating the same thing over and over again? You know, what's the creative process there?
Well, it's almost, I get more requests for, you know, people always wanting to change things for sake of changing it.
Okay.
Rather than, you know, sticking with something. And either one actually works if you do one thing, and it's measurement.
Ah, back to those KPIs, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's sticking with what works more than sticking with, you know, necessarily the same thing. You know, that can get stagnant, but certain campaigns, and these are big campaigns, you know, they're still running the same types of campaigns of, you know, like the Absolute campaign that, you know, have the images of the bottle within the artwork, you know, that they placed. And although, you know, the ad changed, it was the same format, you know, just different artwork, but it had the same kind of, you know, design idea. So that's kind of a hybrid, right? You're kind of sticking with the same thing, but you're changing it.
Yeah.
And some ads, you know, I would say change too often. You know, like they change up things so much that people, you know, can't get used to, you know, finding you and recognizing you and saying, oh, that's that ad that has the, you know, the Geico in it or whatever.
Right. So, yeah.
I would say, you know, measurement is really the capital concern, because if it's not working, abandon. You know, that's my philosophy, is that, look, if it's not working and you're not getting any traction on it, you're not getting phone calls, you're not getting emails, you're not getting sales, you know, it's got to ring the register for us to stick with it.
Makes sense.
Yeah. So that's the main takeaway of, you know, whether you keep something the same, you know, or if it's working, is knowing if it's working.
Yeah, I notice a lot of the TV commercials that are out there, and of course, the our audience and ourselves,
You know, typically we're not marketing to a national TV audience. It's local stuff. So it's either newspaper ads, it's social media ads, email blasts, you know, things like that. But it seems like on the TV ads, a lot of them will come up with a very clever ad. You mentioned Geico, and they're a good example. Actually, most of the insurance companies, it seems like, are good examples. Well, they'll bring a fairly long ad, so it's got a great storyline to it, and then they cut it up in pieces and just play parts of it back and forth, because they've got that opportunity that you know the storyline now, so you kind of, I guess you kind of fill it in your head. That seems to be more of a challenge for smaller industries. So I guess that's where your idea came from, or what you mentioned about keeping the same format, but you're changing pieces of it.
I believe that we're on the same page. It's the idea that, look, it's about what's the word I'm looking for? It's about
repetition.
Yeah, repetition leads to something being familiar. Like, so you remember it, and when you remember something, it looks familiar. You trust it. You know, and when you trust something, that's the one, you know, you're more apt to buy.
Yeah.
So when you lose your look and feel, if you're not recognizable for your brand, then you're kind of missing the point of, you know, reach and repetition, you know, reaching your market. These are old advertising media terminology. You know, reach is how far your message goes, how many people you're reaching. Repetition is how many, times that person might see your ad to kind of saturate that imagery or saturate that message. And it takes a lot, you know. I mean, we're all so distracted with stuff, so not being consistent is a detriment, or especially early on when nobody's your product. The bigger guys, you know, they're spending millions of dollars. You're seeing this stuff constantly, so the scale up and the saturation point of repetition is very quick, you know, because sure, you see it right away, you see it all the time. So when you think of something, you know, yeah, sure, it comes to mind.
Yeah.
I think so it's not, you know, it's not in your best interest, at least early on when nobody knows who you are, or you're trying to gain, you know, notoriety, is to, you know, change up that image too much or change up the message too much. You want it to evolve, obviously, to address new, you know, technologies or concerns or things that, you know, you want, features that you want to, but the look and feel, overall look and feel, should always be recognizable to your brand.
One of the things you talk about in this week's SmartPRENEUR blog is really the concept that marketing is an investment and not an expense. I've been through it myself in organizations. I'm going back far enough before you and I started working together 40 years ago, something like that, where, you know, I really, stressed about how much I was spending on this, versus investing. Would you mind taking the SmartPRENEURs, you know, through that philosophy or let me change it up a bit, not a philosophy, but the reality. That's what you're talking about.
I would love to. I'm going to use an example that I use in a presentation that I do about marketing, and it's about selling pizzas. And you have a pizza shop.
Yep.
And you're starting this pizza shop, and obviously there's lots of competition around, but you're a master pizza maker, you're set on, you know, selling good pizzas. So you want to open your store, and you figure out that selling 100 pizzas a day, man, that's your goal to start. You know, to keep you going, keep your family fed. And, you know, the first day out, you know, you do a pretty good job and, you know, you sell 50 pizzas. So you're going to call the supplier up, and you're going to for the next day. And here's the critical question is, you can sell 50 pizzas and you've got enough, you know, to make 50 pizzas for the next day. Do you order another 50 fixings so that you can reach your goal to make 50, to make, sell 100 pizzas tomorrow? Mm-hmm. Or do you hold off, see how tomorrow goes, sell your 50 pizzas and know that, hey, you know what, let me see how I do tomorrow, and then I'll just order what I need as I go along. Well, you're already defeated.
Yep.
If 100 pizzas is your goal, marketing is what's going to make up the difference.
Ah, okay.
So you have to think of, what do I need to do to sell 100 pizzas a day? That's marketing. And that's what the, you know, that's what the entrepreneurs do when they come up with, well, let's deliver pizzas. Nobody delivers pizzas. Let's sell more pizza because we're offering free delivery. Oh, okay. Well, maybe that's a way to, that's marketing. Well, maybe we'll put a free salad, you know, some lettuce and some tomatoes that cost you 5 cents. You know, maybe we'll put a free salad in with, you know, with the pizza, or we'll give you free breadsticks, or we'll, you know, we'll do a 2-for-1, you know, whatever it is that you need to do to get people to try your pizza. Sell 100 pizzas is what marketing helps you do. And once you figure that out, then you can grow to the next step and do more marketing so that you can sell 200 pizzas.
Right. Makes sense.
Yeah.
So the more you invest, the more you get back.
Yeah. So the idea that, you know, one is, you know, are you investing in your goal? You know, or are you, you know, just trying to, you know, you're already defeated by, you know, just acquiescing to whatever you can do. And that's why marketing is one of the pillars, you know, of entrepreneurship, which is, you know, having your financing in order, you know, your banking and everything else. And then, you know, having legally, you know, a legal pillar of making sure that you're doing everything in compliance. And, you know, marketing is also one of those pillars that should have a return on your investment, not be something that you do because you think you have to, or you think that you're, you know, just supporting the community by, you know, sponsoring the kids' baseball team and stuff like that, which are good things, as long as, you know, you understand maybe some of that stuff, you know, you're doing as a charitable donation rather than marketing. You know, so marketing should have a column in your finances as for a return. That if we put, you know, $5,000 into a digital campaign on LinkedIn, you know, I want to see not just my $5,000 back, you know, but I want to see a profit there. I want to know that I gained a customer or two, you know, that brought me, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars or tens of thousands of dollars for that effort. You know, one job, right? You know, knowing you know, what one customer's value is, so that you, when you put that investment out there and say, well, I need two new customers to make a profit. One customer will break me even for the campaign, but one more customer is going to put me in a, you know, in a return situation where it's going to make a profit. Then it's worth it. If it's not working, don't do it. You know, like, you got to measure it, try it and measure it, and stop doing what's not working until you find something that works.
Makes sense. So going back to the you know, wash and repeat concept, we've talked a little bit about creating new content earlier in the conversation, but going back to repeatability, how do you essentially say the same thing over and over again, but just change it a little bit so it seems fresh? What's your general idea behind that concept?
I mean, it's a little bit of an art. I mean, you have to have, you know, we have professional copywriters that are master of words and, you know, the way of saying things and the way language, you know, understanding language and how a certain audience resonates to certain words or certain, you know, pattern of words, meaning, like, you know, when something is clever, you know, in a headline, or something that is a pun, you know, that means something and it can attract somebody and thinks that it's funny or interesting, or that's where that comes in. You know, it's playing with the words, wordsmithing it so that, yeah, you're saying the same things, but You could say it in a fun, new, interesting, different way. And that's a real important part of differentiating, you know, yourself in the marketplace too, is finding, you know, what's different about you, you know, what's different, what differentiates you from your competition. And how do you say it, you know, as a new feature, you know, in a different way. I remember there was a famous Arm & Hammer, you know, baking soda campaign where they said, hey, if you put the box of baking soda in your refrigerator and keep it there, you know, it takes out the odors.
Right.
And that was one way of making it different, right? You know, that you can use it for, you know, making cakes and stuff, but hey, put that open box. Don't just throw it away. It's pretty useful. So better than the other brand, right? Then they came up with an even more brilliant, you know, plan, which was, did you know that the baking soda in the refrigerator refreshed your drain, right? So if you poured the stuff down the drain, you know, it would freshen up the drain. So they literally got you to buy baking soda to throw it down the drain.
Right.
It was brilliant.
All right, Manny, thanks for your insights today.
Yeah, my pleasure, Tom.
And, smartpreneurs, make sure you're washing and rinsing and repeating on a regular basis, right?
Yeah, yeah. Find what works and keep doing it.
Keep on doing what works. It makes sense. Yeah. If you want to read a little bit more about this, you can go over to simplylabel.com and check out the smartpreneur blog series. And you'll see Marketing, Wash, Rinse, and Repeat by Manny Salomon in there. If you want to watch more of these podcasts, you can also go to simplylabel.com and watch them. You can see us on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/simplyreliable. Apple Podcasts also provides the video version of this podcast. Or you can listen to us anywhere you normally listen to podcasts. Just search out Smartpreneur Podcast. And Manny, if one of our smartpreneurs wanted to get a hold of you and dig a little deeper with you and see if maybe you can bring some value to their business, how would they get in touch with you?
You can find our contact information at our website, whatwedobest.com. Marketing what you do best is what we do best.
That's great. Thanks for being with us today, Manny.
Thanks, Tom.
And thank you, smartpreneurs, for joining us on the Smartpreneur Podcast. We'll see you again next time.